Hey, how y'all doing? You need to stop strutting. You don't even have tail feathers. That is not attractive to the females. He lost all his tail feathers and the chicken's eating his butt. So, women do not find that attractive. No, they don't. But I'm sorry. Hey, no, stop that. Stop that. I'm trying to film here. Oh, you're ruining my program. Go away. Okay, there we go. Totally unscripted butt pecking. Rascal, come on. I'm not going to squirt you. When's the last time I squirted you with a hose? Never. Come on over here. Rascal. Come on. There. See? Everything's okay. Look, Lewis is coming over. You can gnaw on his face. Oh, that feels good. Anyway, good morning, everybody, and welcome to the farm. I wanted to do a really quick episode, and a very simple episode, to inform you of a few things that should be coming. You won't be sniffing him. Watch out. He'll hit you. We got a standoff here. Who's going to win? One of them's got to back off. He's stomping and getting ready to slam into him, and he's getting ready to chew his face. Communication. Aha! Rascal wins another one. Good dog. Anyway, what I wanted to help you with is keeping your pets happy and healthy, because they are our responsibility. We are their caretakers. So I wanted to just briefly hit upon a couple points for people. It is humid. It is just an uncanny humid. Hi there, sweetie. It is uncanny humid right now. This is early, early morning before the sun comes up. Sun will be coming up and it is going to hit in the 90s with a humidity like you would not believe. This can be harmful, even deadly, for animals. We think of it in human terms. Don't leave your babies in the car, you know, unless you're really stupid. Don't leave your babies in the car. Don't leave your kids in the car for just a minute or so. I've seen it on the news. Kids are being taken to the hospital. One kid even died. And I hate to bring up really horrid things like this in my programs, but summer can be a danger. It's not just a fun gardening time. It can also be a danger. You gotta use your common sense in and out of the garden. And so when I saw that program about the small child, I felt so bad. I wanted to bring it to your attention, especially with the pets. Since I don't have kids, I'm not going to do a program about kids. But to keep your babies, your pets, a little bit more comfortable, if you have chickens, a lot of us do have chickens, or if you have friends that have chickens, make sure the water is changed regularly. Water in a dark bowl like this can heat up very, very hot. This is the only water bowl I have, so I have to keep a very good eye on it. I keep it in the shade of a tree, so it does keep cooler, but I also change the water because they appreciate fresh, cold water. Not just regular water, but cold water. When I refill it with cold water, the chickens and the turkeys come running, and this one here does her little river dance. She tap dances in the water. And I've shown a picture. Let me show a picture really quick of what this thing does. Yep, that's what she does. She just lays. It's her little kiddie pool. She lays in the water, but she really does love her water. Uh-oh, no. Let's not have anything that's not family friendly here. You need to go away now. Go away. Go on. Don't ruin my program. You guys can make happy later. All right. Sorry you had to see the violence in my programs. But anyway, keep some shade for your chickens. If your chickens are outside, you know, some people will have these chicken tractors, you know, and that's basically a portable structure that's fenced in and it has a roof, and you can move it all over your lawn and let your chickens peck on the grass. Well, they don't stop and think. These chickens are out in the sun, even though they may have a little bit of shade. Sometimes people make it out of dark material, like dark metal, and that metal can get really, really hot. So being in that shade really doesn't help that bird at all. Chickens will put their wings out and they'll open their mouth and they'll pant. That's the only way that they have to stay cool, and it isn't enough. They actually need some real shade. They need fresh water, and sometimes you just got to have some tough love. If you have a coop like I do, sometimes you can't let them out during the heat of the day because they're not the brightest of creatures. I gotta say it. You know, they are beautiful, fun creatures, but they're not the brightest of creatures. Turkeys, also. I've seen this guy sitting out in the sun wondering where his life went wrong. Well, your life went wrong when you went out of the coop. Females are a little bit smarter. And also, don't be scared if your chickens stop laying all of a sudden. Chickens will do that, and it's a heat issue. Sometimes when the heat comes on, the chickens will stop laying for a while. You need to go away. Hey, go away. Go on. Go on. This is not happy fun time. This is a raised program. And your pets. Of course, common sense. You know, I'm preaching that all the time in my programs for my garden. Common sense, especially when it comes to your pets. Don't leave your pet in your car for a minute. Even if I've heard people make the excuse, oh, I cracked the windows. You sit in a hot car on a sunny day with the windows cracked just a little bit and see how hot it gets. It is uncanny how hot it can get in there. And even though your pet may not die, that pet is uncomfortable. And it's your responsibility as this animal's caretaker, because the animal can't take care of itself. It relies 100% on you. That animal needs to be comfortable. If it's too hot in the car, leave the animal at home. If it's inconvenient for you, that's the price you pay for taking on the responsibility for this animal. Maybe put it in the bathroom and bring up the rugs and take everything away that the animal can chew on, lock the door, and put some water in there for the animal to keep it off your furniture and from tearing things up if you don't trust your animal. Do whatever you need to do to keep your pets safe during this hot weather, okay? Because it just kills me inside. Every time I see an article or I see a news program about a child or an animal or a person being hurt from the heat that we're having right now, and it doesn't have to happen. Common sense can help all of this. A fan, you know, when him and I go to bed, a little crackhead, I'm pointing over here because he doesn't want to be on camera today, a little crazy dog. Him and I sleep in the same bed. Yes, we do. I sleep in the same bed with my dog, and I have a fan in there. And I point the fan at us, and he just loves it. He just lays out and just kicks himself out and just enjoys the heck out of that fan. Even if you don't have air conditioning, the fan will help. But anyway, just a short safety message for you, your pets, to keep you all happy and healthy. Please use your common sense and be very aware during this hot season, all right? When you take your animals, Ray's gonna fall right real quick. When you take your animals out, remember, pavement gets incredibly hot. And these animals, their paws have sensitivity. You may not think so. They do. They have sensitivity. Don't take your animal out on pavement when it's hot. Keep them on the grass, or don't take them out at all. They'd rather be bored than be dead, okay? So I just wanted to bring this to your attention to try to help you just a little bit, and also to spread a little bit of awareness, because this is what I do. There are different ways in this world that we try to help animals. Some people go out and they're activists. Some of them go out and help with adoption. Some of them help at pounds and shelters. I try to spread the word as much as I possibly can to my audience. That's just my way of doing things. It's a little tiny drop in a very big bucket. But if we all work together and just spread the word to help these animals who can't help themselves, I think it would be a little bit better for all of us. Anyway, that is my short program for helping our pets. And if you have any ideas, any good tips for helping pets, to keeping animals safe, please feel free to post it in the comment section below. People would be glad to read this, because anything we can do to help is something that is really, I think, a good thing and is going to help our pets have a really good day. Okay, Rascal, come on over. Don't be so shy. Come on. He's kind of bummed out because he can't go out and chase bunnies today. I called him over here. He wants to go running. Rascal, come here. You're okay. Yeah. Okay. We're going to go out and play in the garden right now. Yeah. Go see bunny? Want to go see the bunny? Yeah, you do. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day. Let's go, baby. It's bunny.